Dear student, this is question number 40 from S. C. Verma, Concept of Physics, from the chapter Electric Field and Potential. In this question, actually what is given? Let's see, a rod of length L has a total charge Q distributed uniformly along its length. It is bent in the shape of a semicircle. Find the magnitude of electric field at the center of curvature of the semicircle. Let this is the center of curvature. O is the center of curvature here. In order to calculate the radius, you have to compare the length. Then L can be written as pi r. Pi r is the length of semicircle. Now, from here, r can be calculated by L upon pi. In order to calculate net electric field at point O, you have to divide this semicircular ring in small differential element, because we are using the Coulomb's law here. Coulomb's law can be applied only for the point charges. Let dq is the point, smallest point charge here. And due to this charge, electric field acting at point O can be taken by this way. And this electric field can be written as D. You know, if this is angle theta, suppose that this is angle theta, this angle can be taken as d theta. Now, if this angle is theta, or alternative angle, you can write this is also theta. Now, two component can be resolved due to d. One is d sine theta along x-axis, and along y-axis you can say that is d cos theta. Similar for the element, if you take symmetrically in other side, that this is theta, and electric field at point O due to this dq, that will be d. Again, you will get two components. If this is angle theta, this angle theta, that will be d sine theta, and downward direction it will be d cos theta. This is the rough diagram. Now, in order to calculate net field at point O, if you see carefully along x-axis, these component can be cancelled out due to 180 degree symmetry. It means net field is only acting along y-axis. Then net field can be written as integration. Why integration? Because there are number of elements due to small elements, and that's why d cos theta can be calculated by integration. So that will be d cos theta, integration of all. This is suppose that equation. Now, you have to calculate the value of dE here. dE means electric field due to small charge dq. That's why it can be written as 4 pi epsilon naught. R is constant, that's why it is r square. Now you have to calculate the value of differential element dq. It can be written by comparing linear density. dq upon r d theta is equal to q upon pi r. Pi r means half length. Why r d theta? You go to the basic definition of angle. If this is angle d theta and this is radius fixed r, this particular r can be written as r d theta. Now, if you see carefully, rr get cancelled out, and finally you will get dq is equal to q upon d theta. Then d can be written as d is equal to q upon 4 pi, pi pi get multiplied, will be pi square, epsilon naught 1 upon r square d theta. Now put in equation 1. When you put in equation 1, electric field can be written as E at point O is equal to integration of q upon 4 pi epsilon naught r square. four pi square in fact, epsilon naught into r square cos theta, and d theta. Further, it can be solved by this way. Net field at point O, you can take outside the integration, q upon 4 pi square epsilon naught r square, inside the integration only cos theta and d theta. When you check the limit will be minus pi by 2 plus pi by 2. Reason, because when you go left hand side or right hand side clockwise, you will get the clockwise, you will get minus pi by 2, and anti-clockwise plus pi by 2. Now solve it. EO can be written as EO is equal to q upon 4 pi square epsilon naught r. Integration of cos theta can be as sine theta, and limits are minus pi by 2, 2 plus 2. Now EO can be written as q upon 4 pi square epsilon naught r, in fact r square, that is sine pi by 2 minus sine minus pi by 2. Close it. E naught can be written as q upon 4 pi square epsilon naught r square. Here pi by 2 is 1, and minus theta is minus theta, that's why minus 1. And finally it become 2. When it become 2, you can solve further. EO is equal to 2q upon 4 pi square epsilon naught r square. And in final way you can write net field at point O can be written as 2 will cancel out. Here we have only q. And one more thing you can notice here, that is r is equal to l by pi. If r is l by pi, you have to put the 4 pi square epsilon naught in place of r square, that is l square, pi square will go in numerator. And finally when you simplify this problem, you will get pi square will cancel out, and 2 already cancel out. It will be EO is equal to q upon 2 epsilon naught into L square. This is the final result from this question, and this question is very very helpful for you in future. Even if you want to convert any shape, one shape to another shape, in order to distribution of charge in electric field, by this way you have to use the calculus. Thank you very much.